Recently, we released a video on the shooting board, and there was one question that came up more than anything, and it was, why doesn't the hand plane cut the shooting board? So I want to show you real quick. So here's the answer. The answer is yes and no. It does cut the shooting board somewhat, but it never loses its reference area. And here's why. This distance between the blade and the side of the plane obviously can't cut because there's no blade there. In fact, that is exactly 1/4 inch. Now, if we look down here, you can see there is a light colored piece of wood and a dark where the metal has been rubbing against it. That is our original reference area. And you can see that is the exact same distance. This dark part is the exact same distance as the distance of the side of the plane to the blade, which is 1/4 inch. And you can see this lighter colored wood, that's where it has been cutting it. And that's okay because you never lose that reference because the plane always rides against that reference area and will never change the angle of your shooting board or the distance in which it can go in. In fact, if you look down here where our fence is, and this is why I make it adjustable, is because then I can line it up with where the cut area is and not the reference area down here, because that's where we're gonna stop our tear out. And so if we set it just beyond that, maybe like a hair's width, then I'm never gonna cut this fence. Even if I do, that's fine because it's basically just running along the same thing. So it's not like we're taking it out of square, and this area doesn't matter at all. You're only worried about this. This reference face here compared to this reference face here, which never gets cut. So there's your answer to, does your hand plane cut your shooting board?